Hi, I'm Mark Collins. I'm Applications Engineer here at HUI. Today we're going to talk about 60601 tests dealing with instability from unwanted lateral movement in transport and non-transport mode. The purpose of this test is to check the braking strength of your locking wheels. So anything more than 50 millimeters of initial creepage would be a failure. So here is our cart. It is in our transport mode, which is called out in the instructions for use documentation. It has an adjustable height working surface, so it's in its lowest position. Its directional locking wheels are locked. Our incline is at 10 degrees, and so now we're just going to go through and make sure that there is no creepage or slip more than 50 millimeters. So this cart passes, there's no sliding at 10 degrees. We have our cart ready for our non-transport mode test, which includes lowering the ramp down to 5 degrees, increasing the center of gravity, so moving the cart up as high as it can. In this case, we have a monitor that swivels, so worst case would be the monitor coming over towards the downhill side. We have directional wheels, so we will put those wheels in the worst case orientation, and then we will lock the wheels and check for creepage. So this car passes in the non-transport mode. There is no sliding past 50 millimeters. So the last portion of the test is the lateral forces test. Basically what that is we're going to lower our incline down to zero, or it's just horizontal. We have to apply a 15% force of the total weight of the cart. In this case, that's 17.1 pounds. We have to apply that force in every direction. And what we're looking for is to make sure that there's enough braking strength so that the cart does not slide. I'm going to use my force gauge, zero it out. And at first I'm going to push on the cart. And I'm going to push up to 17.1 pounds and make sure that there's no movement, which we're good. And then now I'm going to pull on the cart. And as I pull, I have to get up to 17.1, and you can see that the cart is starting to slide. So that constitutes a failure. So that's pretty common for carts that have two locking wheels on the same side of the cart. What we'd try to do to fix this, we would move one of those locking wheels to opposite corner so that we have equal braking forces on the cart. We've changed the configuration of our casters, so now we have locking wheels on opposite corners. So we're going to rerun our test. We're going to apply a force in every direction, making sure to change our casters into the least favorable position. So once again, we start out. We're going to push on our cart up to 17.1 pounds, making sure that we don't have any sliding. There we go, we're good. Change our wheels. No movement. Okay. So by changing the configuration of the wheels, we were able to pass the test. However, I would say that this is not a common configuration. Most carts we've seen in the market go from two locking wheels to four locking wheels. If you do want a directional lock, generally you would just put one on. And that is how you test your cart for instability of unwanted lateral movement in the transport non-transport mode. Thanks for watching.